I met Kristen, and I was chairman of the Department of Neurobiology and Physiology. And I was looking for the, what at that time was called the secretary to the chair. And the next day, Kristen walked in and interviewed for the job. And I hired her, and she actually became part of the team, so to speak, from a science point of view.
Initially, this was just a job while I figured out what I wanted to do. But when I worked for Fred, I learned a lot about sleep and circadian science. And I decided to sort of shift focus in graduate school and start looking at sleep and human health from an anthropological perspective.
My work is a study of 24-hour rhythms or circadian rhythms. Many of the adverse effects of having circadian disruption leads to sleep disruption, and the two of them together can affect the health of the organism. And so I started a sleep laboratory. I think it's fair to say that we were one of the founding institutions which attempted to bring sleep and circadian rhythms together.
My interest in research on looking at both sleep and circadian rhythms is trying to understand how sleep disruption or circadian disruption may increase risk of different chronic diseases. In particular, I've looked at obesity, diabetes, cardiovascular disease, and more recently I'm looking at cognitive function. I feel sleep and circadian disruption may play a role in health disparities.
Kristen and I are often engaged in conversations about the research I'm doing in animals that are similar to the research she's doing in humans. And by working with Kristen, it reminds me all the time to think about, okay, what is the importance of this from just the health point of view?
The overarching goal of my research is ultimately to figure out how can we improve sleep or circadian timing to improve human health.